Thank you. Fotos nachher drum gewundert.
Well, good evening and welcome to the WSF Women's World Team Championships 2022. We are in Cairo at the Madinati Sporting Club for the 22nd edition of this historic event. Second time here in Cairo. Number one seeds Egypt looking to defend their title on home soil. So let's have a look at the different groups. You can see there, number one seeds, Egypt, the top of Pool A. Number two seeds, United States. They've got a fantastic team there in Pool B. Pool C, topped by number three seeds, England. And then we've got five nations in Pool D with Chinese Taipei there competing for the first time at these championships, making their debut, which is fantastic. So 17 nations competing in total. So great turnout. Obviously this event hasn't been on for a while. 2020 edition was canceled for obvious reasons. So it's great to have this back on the calendar. Simon Park joining me in commentary this week. Evening, Parky.
Good evening, Vanessa. Great to be here in new Cairo. Obviously, we've got a very, very strong Egyptian side here, the top three in the world, plus number six. It's got to be just about the strongest side in any World Team Championships, men and women, I would have thought.
Well, the order of play for today, for all the teams, is 1-3-2. So the number one strings coming up first, and that is, of course, the world number one, Noreen Gohar. She's taking on Cindy Merlo. That will be followed by Nur Altayeb and Amber Alinx. And then the third match, Hania El-Hamami taking on Nadia Pfister. Plenty of action going on the other courts as well. So you can see there, Noreen Gohar warming up on the left-hand side. And her opponent, Cindy Merlo, on the right. Cindy Merlo is 24 years old. She's sat just inside the top 50 currently at 48. She's from Vault in Switzerland. So this is a huge moment for her, taking on the best player in the world, the number one ranked player. Noreen Gohar, 25 years old, the current world number one, three-time US Open champion and British Open champion as well, of course. Just coming here off the back of Hong Kong, where she lost out in the semi-final. Huge battle against the eventual winner, Hania El-Hamami. Gohar's got a very good record at these World Team Championships, Parky. She was part of the team that took this title in 2016 and 2018, so she's got a clean record at World Teams.
Yeah, she has. She hasn't got quite as many World Team Championships as yourself. 10 consecutively. I just thought I'd get that one in for you.
Thank you. That's
a record, I believe.
Consecutive ones, I
think.
Consecutive.
Yeah. I think Derek Ryan's probably up there in terms of amount of World Team Championships played. I only played five, so it feels a little bit pathetic compared to you.
Terrible.
But
and you played for a poor nation as well.
Yeah. Yeah, Goha is obviously spearheading this incredibly strong Egyptian team here in Egypt, in front of the home fans. Tall task for Switzerland today, but they look like they're going to enjoy it.
Why not? Cindy Merlot looking to get her team off to a good start.
Well, we know she can play a little bit. She's top 50 in the world, Cindy Merlot. She's no pushover, but of course, she's playing the best of the best here in Cairo. See Nora Goha just getting a few words of advice.
Angie Correa, she was in the Egyptian team when I was playing.
Play will start
coaching the team
seconds.
This week. The man in charge.
Women's World Team Championships 2022, Pool A, first string match. Cindy Merlot of Switzerland to serve, Nuran Gohar of Egypt to receive. Best of five games. Love all.
So as we could see from the Swiss team just leading into this first match, they looked in good spirits. Obviously, there's no pressure here whatsoever. They can just go out there and enjoy it against the best in the world, Vanessa.
Absolutely. I mean, they're coming out in the first match of a World Team Championships against the top seeds. This, as I said, this championship hasn't been played for quite a while, so it's a big moment, really, for all involved. Such a great event.
Yeah, of course, the main challengers really are USA and England, but England missing Gina Kennedy for this event, unfortunately. Still a strong side, though. But the USA looking like they've got a really good side. Four of the top 20, I believe, or 25 in their squad.
Yeah, really strong US team.
And France have got Camille Serm back in their side after retirement, which will be interesting to see how she's playing. I'm sure she'll put up a strong challenge.
Oh, absolutely. Playing number two string. She'll be a very strong number two against anyone. Goha looking sharp from that middle area as she does with that low kill.
I can't get over the fact that Egypt's reserve number four player is number six in the world, Nour El Tayeb.
No, it's ridiculous.
And of course, another top 10 player, Rona Larrabee, not actually making it into the side.
Well, yeah, that used to be the case for England, didn't it? That, you know, the really, really top established players wouldn't quite make the team. It's the price you pay for coming from one of the best nations in the world in terms of squash.
Yeah, it's very true. I think on the men's and the women's side, for England, you had to be pretty much top 20 in the world. And now for Egypt, of course, it looks like you've got to be top five, top six.
Well, it's a very different feeling coming out and playing for your country as opposed to, you know, playing a first round of a PSA event.
I used to quite enjoy it because, of course, squash is an individual sport. It can get quite lonely touring the world on your own. We don't have big entourages like they do in tennis. And I used to like playing the team events, sort of getting all that support from your friends on the bench. And then, obviously, you know, paying the favour back. I would play 10-20% better playing for England.
Yeah, I mean, there's plenty of examples of players that played some of their best squash during team events for that very reason, just having that supportive environment.
Merlot's doing well here. It's a pretty good scoreline. She looks confident, not overawed against the world number one. well straightened from the Swiss. I guess one advantage of playing the very top players is that you'll have seen them a lot more than they've seen you, because they're always on TV every week, aren't they, in the latter stages.
Absolutely.
Over the years.
Plenty of opportunities to have a look at them and try and work out some tactics. And, you know, we're sort of at the end of the first half of the season, aren't we? So a lot of the top players have played a huge amount of squash, particularly in this last phase with the tour in Asia. Gohar actually less so, because she didn't compete in Singapore or Malaysia, but has come here pretty quickly after Hong Kong.
Yeah, I think she had, was it semi-final berth in Hong Kong, losing out to Hamami, who eventually won the event. Hamami, she's probably the most informed player, I'd say, on the tour at the moment.
11-4, game to Egypt. Egypt leads one game to love.
So, Noran Gohar closing out that first game. Takes it 11-4 in just 5 minutes. So Egypt leading this first match by one game to love.
Well, when you're just inside the top 50 in the world and you're playing against the number one player on the planet in her home country, you could be pretty nervous, but Cindy Merlo did a great job here of staying in the rallies, looking pretty confident, looking like she was enjoying her squash. That was nice, taking the ball early on that boast, trying to take the game to Noran Gohar, but it's Gohar, this one leads by one game to love.
Well, a decent turnout, Parky, for this first match.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive for a first group game.
Egypt,
I think Egypt will be playing a lot on this court for obvious reasons.
A nice setup here, Madinati Club.
Yeah, there's lots going on, lots of kids here. Not necessarily watching the squash, but just a really good environment. There's paddle courts, tennis courts. Wow. Lots of sports going on here, lots of activity.
Two love.
Apparently, Vanessa, there's 42,000 families registered at this club. It's
wow.
Phenomenal. I mean, it's pretty big, but I didn't realize it was that big.
Yeah, a lot of the players tend to be part of these big kind of almost outdoor leisure centres, don't they, that squash is just a part of. Got this outdoor court that's been set up for this event, but there's also an indoor glass court. England are playing South Africa as we speak on that court, and then there's another two, well, there's loads of other courts, but two being used for this championship, two traditional courts.
Just snatched at that one a little bit, Merlo. I think that's what tends to happen sometimes when you're playing the very top players. You just try a little bit too much. Happened again there on the return of serve. I think Merlo's game herself is a little bit attacking as well, and she's playing not just against the world number one, but one of the most attacking players around. think sometimes you might just have to try and adjust your tactics slightly.
Well, she's looking like she's really off the pace here in this second game. Everything happening a little bit too fast for Merlo. That's better. She's got a little bit more depth on her drives in that rally. Was able to move Gohar away from that tee position.
Oh, that was quite beautiful drive, that one, Vanessa. Perfect technique on the forehand side. The preparation, look at this preparation. So early.
On that one in a flash.
Wonderful shot. She's got to be the best striker of the ball, the best timer in the women's game, would you say? I mean, her mum is pretty good as well, but just for pure timing.
Yeah, yeah.
Shabini plays a different kind of game. It's not all about power, is it? It's a bit more sort of thoughtful, I guess.
Yeah, she certainly hits the ball with a lot of pace, pretty relentlessly, Gohar.
Very, very sound technique, though. That's why she times it so well. The preparation is faultless, really.
Taking that volley again so early. There's no time for Merlo to recover. She's raced to game ball.
Yeah, Gohar probably feeling that Merlo got a few too many points in that first, looking a little bit more ruthless in this second.
Well, just 4 minutes for that second game. Gohar taking it 11-2 and leading by 2 games to love.
So Gohar looking so much more ruthless in that second game on the court, nice and early. Just sending out a message to her opponent, the number 48 in the world currently, Cindy Merlo.
Play will resume in 60 seconds.
The message wasn't strong enough. She's just reinforcing it after that second game. Just bringing in the towel boxes. I would have quite liked to have played with the towel box, Vanessa. Seconds. Just get a little bit of a rest here and there.
Yeah, they tend to be used quite tactically at times.
15 seconds.
Merlo with a huge amount of work to do here. Needs to try and extend this a little bit. Maybe look to control the pace a little bit more.
2 games to love. Love all.
If you were in her corner, how would you suggest that she does that?
I mean, it becomes less about, you know, you're not really thinking at this point about, you know, winning the match. You're just trying to get what you can from this and keep her on there a bit longer, maybe. Try and think about, you know, what sort of tactics you need to employ to get as many points on the board as you can. And this pace is just, it's just happening too fast, isn't it? She needs to somehow slow this down.
Would you be about duration or points against Gohar?
No, you're right. It doesn't necessarily mean that you're doing the right thing just because you've extended the rallies. I think it's more about just trying to employ the tactics that you want to, that you think are the best tactics to use against an opponent, and stick to that game plan and not worry really about how many points that brings you, but at least feel like you've stuck to your game plan.
That you're achieving what you're trying to achieve.
Yeah.
Sticking to it.
And I think that probably is the right game plan, to try and get that ball running into the back a little bit more.
I think a bit straighter as well. A bit, like you say, mixing up the paces, slowing down the pace, using... I don't think she's really lobbed at all in this match. But like I say, I think she does have an attacking mindset herself. And at her level, obviously, that's pretty successful at 48 in the world. You don't get to that ranking without being a very good player. But obviously, Gohar is a different kettle of fish. And I think mixing up the lobs and a bit of straighter stuff, like you say, trying to extend the rallies would be useful. But it looks like it's a little bit too late here.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like her natural game, as you said, is to try and attack from the middle like she did there. But those opportunities are few and far between. You're going to have to work very hard to get into those positions.
That's one for the scrapbook, isn't it? Against Gohar.
Yeah.
Right back at you.
And out.
Just not messing around here, Gohar. Just demonstrating to her star-studded teammates just how it's done.
Wow,
this is disappearing at a rate of knots.
She got it, did really well there. Down. Did really well, Merlot, to chase that. It's very impressive and just squeezed the error out of Gohar. There they are. What a team that is.
Oh, goes for the little half volley, but never really on.
Just couldn't quite get the timing right.
Can you check that? I don't think it was out. Ball called out. Giving Gohar 7 match balls.
Too good from Gohar. That's a nice warm embrace at the end of that match. These two, Merlo, put up a good fight, Vanessa.
She did. It was always a big task for the Swiss player. Gohar getting her team off to a good start at these championships. Just 18 minutes. Dispatcher Cindy Merlo, 3 games to love. 11-4, 11-2, 11-3. So Egypt leading 1-love. Three string match will be up next. And it is Noor El Tayeb. She is taking on Amber Alinks. That'll be on in a matter of moments.
Thank you.
Our number three string match coming up, and it is Noor El Tayeb taking on Amber Alinks of Switzerland. So Alinks on the left of your screen, just 20 years old, competing here for the first time at the World Team Championships. Currently sat just outside the top 100. She's 105 in the world from Lucerne in Switzerland. She's got a tough task ahead, playing against Noor El Tayeb, 29-year-old. Currently sat at 6 in the world. She's been very active recently. She was the runner-up at the Singapore Open just a few weeks ago, and then quarter-finalist at the Hong Kong Open, where she lost to her teammate, Hania El Hamami. She's a former US Open champion, of course. Long-time member of this Egyptian women's team. This very successful Egyptian women's team, looking to defend their title. 2018 was the last time this championship was held. That was in Dalian in China, Egypt winning that. So a must-win match for Switzerland, Parkey. Gohar getting off to a great start with the 3-love win against Cindy Merlo.
Yeah, absolutely. With the three-woman team, it's imperative that you get a win. Win one of the first two matches. Very, very tall order, of course, though, for Alinks.
Time.
Just hasn't got much experience. I'm sure she's going to go on and enjoy it. Seemed like the Swiss team have a really good attitude going on there against Egypt. But Noor El Tayeb, a different player altogether from Gohar. Very, very flexible in her movement, fantastic mover, and very clever in finding the spaces, uses different paces and lots of disguise. Fantastic to watch, Tayeb. Never seen Alinks play, so let's see how she does. Lots of work for the Swiss coach to do today.
Yeah, talking through the tactics, as you can see. Again, it's all about just concentrating on those, on that game plan, trying to get as much as you can out of this match.
Play will start in 15 seconds.
Huge moment for Alinks.
Women's World Team Championships 2022, Pool A match. Noor El Tayeb of Egypt to serve. Amber Alinks of Switzerland to receive. Best of five games, love all.
What would your tactics be against Tayeb, Vanessa?
Certainly to keep the ball quite straight. She really hunts for the cross court around the middle. She's always looking to try and pick
one
players off around
love.
That middle area. She can get quite frustrated against players that can keep the ball quite consistently straight and tight. She likes to play that quite open game, likes to use a lot of variety. And if she's sort of forced into quite a traditional sort of straighter game, she can start to maybe force things, but very, very difficult to do successfully because she's so good. But I would say
down.
That would probably be the main tactic.
Two love.
Well, we're just talking about how Gohar was perhaps the best striker on the women's World Tour. What would you say about Taieb? I would say one of the best readers of the game.
Three, love.
Seems to have a sixth sense and a really good understanding of the space on the court, where she is and where her opponent is, and the best shot to play at that moment. She's got a really good feel for the game, hasn't she?
Yeah, she's very creative. She's always looking to do something on every shot. She uses a lot of variety, a lot of different pace changes within her game. She's got that hold as well. And then backed up with a lot of pace around the court. She's very quick. You know, I've seen her have to just grind it out against players before, and she's got that other side to her game as well, where she can just go into this, I'm just going to get everything back and keep myself in rallies. And she's very, very tough, very gritty when she needs to be.
Love.
Some Egyptian fans. Hopefully we're going to have a few more as the week runs on. I'm sure we will.
Seven, love.
I suspect things are going to be fairly comfortable for Egypt early on.
Down.
Unless there are any major problems, eight, you just can't see anyone pushing them till the later rounds. That's a lovely shot. There's no mercy
nine, love.
Being shown whatsoever
box,
here
please.
From the world number six. Just a bit of a lesson so far, Vanessa.
Yeah, Alex just trying to gain a little bit of time on this court to work things out, but Natalia in absolutely no mood to give her that. Racing to a 10-love lead.
Well, just before that boast happened, even a tight ball was volley lobbed off the side wall from Taieb. That's the kind of confidence that she has at the moment.
Hand out. 1-10, game ball.
Gets a point on the board, much to her relief, I'm sure, but it didn't
11,
last for long.
1, game to Egypt. Egypt leads one game to love.
Well, it's nice to see that Taieb didn't go for the full bagel.
Yeah, possibly just backed off ever so slightly in that rally. 5 minutes for that first game, or Taieb takes it 11-1. Leads by one game to love.
Well, I keep saying it, but the number four in this squad, Nour El-Tayeb, the reserve, number six in the world, looking very, very good after watching her compatriot, the world number one, Gohar, put in a brilliant performance, looking very, very ruthless and on for a bagel here. But it was just the one point that she let slip. Nour El-Tayeb leading one game to love.
Play will resume in 60 seconds. Play will resume in 30 seconds. Egypt leads one game to love. Love all.
And Nour El-Tayeb with a one love lead in this second match of this tie between Egypt and Switzerland. Nour El-Shabini on the bench for this one. I mean, they can pretty much play any order at any time. It makes very little difference, really. Such a strong team. I mean, the order has, I guess, been determined by the most recent rankings, but any given day.
Yeah, I mean, they've got to be one of the best teams ever in sport as a whole. I mean, you look at the Brazilian football team, not this year, of course, but in past years. The USA basketball team, I mean, they're right up there with these legendary sports people over the years. They have to be with those kind of rankings in one team. It's quite phenomenal, really. It should be a Hollywood movie made about these players taking the women's game to a completely new level.
Three love.
It's going to be fascinating to see later in the week if USA do make the final, how they can compete. Obviously, they've got the Sobey sisters and Victor and Olivia Blatchford-Klein. Fantastic team as well. And in many other previous years, they would have won the Women's World Team Championships. But very, very strong team, Egypt, this year.
Well, it's certainly the strongest team that the USA has had before, and it would be certainly be a fantastic final if they were to meet. USA never taken this title, of course.
Handout.
It's only ever been shared by three nations, England, Australia and Egypt. England still pretty strong. They've won the most championships.
Yeah, I think back in the 70s when it was first played, it was won by Great Britain, the home nations amalgamated, but it was just that one time. France, of course, have done pretty well over the years, particularly in the last 20 years, but never actually won the title.
I think it's actually Australia that's won the most. England second. Australia, obviously, during the 90s and early noughties, winning a huge run of titles.
5-1.
Yeah, I think it might have even started in the late 80s, you know, running on from people like Liz Irving and into Michelle Martin, Sarah Fitzgerald. Just such a strong era that was.
And then the Grinhams.
6-1.
And then after that, the Grinhams.
Well, again, for our links, it's all about trying to find those small gains
7-1.
Within this match. You know, even just if you're able to put it together for one rally, and then, you know, you've got to really just take it one step at a time in these sort of situations.
Absolutely. Well, we've got a completely new ball here. The ball went flying over the front wall and
I haven't even bothered to look for it.
it would have been a few miles away. No point in looking for that one.
You can't really see, but we're sort of almost in a courtyard, aren't we?
Yeah.
Outdoors, or as in there's no roof, but it's sort of we're sort of walled in inside a courtyard. There you go.
Beauty shot. It went over that yellow building you're just seeing on the right hand side, going out of shot. So yeah, just a little bit of time to warm the ball up. I tell you what, Alex is doing very, very well in this volley practice.
Yeah, she looks like she hits a nice ball from kind of set positions, but the problem is she's being constantly dragged around the corners and she's never really in that nice balanced set position.
Well, there's the squash center. The other courts are the traditional courts and the permanent glass court.
7-1.
Watch the streaming from that other glass court too. A few yards away from this court. Lots of world-class squash players here this week. A from 17 different nations.
I was looking back at the history in that first World Team Championships in 1979 was six nations competing.
Oh, wow, like the rugby.
2-8.
I think the most that have ever competed was 26.
Wow.
In France, in Nîmes. I can't remember what the year was, but I can look that up.
One of your years, maybe.
It was, yeah. I played that one.
One of your 10. What was the best the Netherlands did?
I think we came fourth one year. I can't remember. I think I'm pretty sure.
Well,
we
I know
came
that
fourth.
You won the Europeans one year. That
Hand
must
out.
Have been
we
around
did.
That time.
9-2.
It's a little intruder at the back of the court there. To the only three winners of the Women's World Team Championships. It's pretty similar in the men's, it being the same three nations plus Pakistan are the only winners of that event too.
10-2, game ball.
It's about time for some other nations to try and take the mantle.
Well,
11-2, game to Egypt. Egypt leads 2-2.
Noral Tayeb races 2-2 lead. In the second match of this tie, 7 minutes, second game. Tayeb takes it 11-2. So after 14 minutes, Egypt leading by 2-2.
Pretty straightforward.
Well, Alex looking quite relaxed on there, considering who she's up against. But Noral Tayeb just offering too much, really. That forehand boast was quite rare for her, one of her favourite shots. But as I pointed out at the beginning of this match, she's just got so much in her artillery, Tayeb. Such a clever squash player. But Alex doing pretty well.
Play will resume in 60 seconds. Play will resume in 30 seconds. Egypt leads 2-0. Love all. One love.
Little one trying to get very close to the action.
Yeah, there's a few offsprings of the coaches and players at the back there. Not sure who they belong to.
It might have been little
one
Farida,
all.
Noral Tayeb's daughter.
A And she's been around the squash a lot, hasn't she, since she came into the world?
Down.
Been all over the world already.
2-1.
That's rare as hen's teeth, that from Nur Altayeb. Just completely mistimed it. Had to be really pedantic. Perhaps just let it drop a bit too low. Maybe lost it in the lights somewhat. My feeling is it's not going to matter too much, though, for Tayeb and Egypt. Oh, look at that. Just gets the ball so, so straight.
Hand out.
Just not clipping the sidewall at all there, Tayeb. And again.
Well,
digs in perfectly, doesn't it?
Alex just being dragged around here, struggling a little bit with the movements she's being forced to make. Being stopped and started as well with the hold. Just creates that extra bit of distance for her opponent to cover with that hold and her swing.
It's
tight work from Tayeb. Good squeeze. When you were world number one, Vanessa, and playing in these kind of team events, and there may be a bit of a chasm between you and opponent, would you be really ruthless on there?
No, it was very nice.
You don't want to be on there too long, though, do you? Especially in a team event.
No, I mean, there has to be a significant difference, because otherwise, you certainly don't want to underestimate your opponent. And you want to try and stay sharp for the later matches when it starts to get a bit tougher.
Yeah, you want a bit of a workout, don't you? I think earlier on in the, particularly the group matches, as you build into the semis and final.
Oh, wow. That's just...
She was ready before her opponent had even started to play that shot.
Stroke to Egypt. 10-2 match ball.
So 8 match balls for Egypt. And the ball goes flying over the front wall.
11-2 match to Egypt. 3 games to love. 11-1, 11-2, 11-2.
Nur Altayeb making pretty light work of that match. 20 minutes, she takes it 3 games to love. 11-1, 11-2, 11-2.
Well, it's a good effort again from Alink. She's just playing against another legend of the game in Nur Altayeb, who's, of course, become a mother in the last couple of years, playing some fantastic squash, found herself back at 6 in the world. It's a real chasm in level, but a nice effort from the young Swiss. Second ball lost. We'll leave that one, but it's matched to Tayeb and matched to Egypt.
Well, one more match to go. And it is Hania El Hamami taking on Nadia Pfister coming up shortly. Welcome back. This is the number two string match between Egypt and Switzerland. Nadia Pfister on the left of your screen there, on the right now for Switzerland. 27 years old. She is up against the world number three, Hania El Hamapi, the player in form at the moment. Just won the tournament in Hong Kong, of course. Beat two of her teammates to win that tournament. Took out Nouran Gohar in the semi-final, and then Noor El Shabini in the final. Two epic matches. Some of the best squash I've ever seen. Looking to close things out here for her country.
Play will start in 15 seconds. Women's World Team Championships 2022 Pool A match. Hania El Hamami of Egypt serve. Nadia Pfister of Switzerland to receive. Best of five games. Love all. Down. One love.
Well, again, another tall order for Swiss player Nadia Pfister here.
One love.
Against the woman in form, Hania El Hamami. The 2022 Hong Kong Open champion.
But that would be the right box, sorry.
El Hamami.
Right box, two love.
Yeah. She's right already box. Challenging the referee. First point in, first couple of points. Doesn't take any prisoners, Hania El Hamami.
Well, this is her first time competing in a World Team Championships. She wasn't in the 2018 squad in China.
Three love. Left box.
I guess she just hadn't quite made that run. She was very young then. She's very young now, of course. Back in 2018, hadn't quite got herself into that top.
Four love.
Top echelons of the game. Certainly has now. That's a good start, Pfister. Just a bit of confidence for her. First point on the board. Hamami, one of the taller players on the tour, but Pfister actually a little bit taller.
2-4.
Good reach for both of these players.
Hand out, 5-2. Down. 6-2. Hand out, 3-6.
That's good stuff. Four, there six. From Pfister. Bit of a, she got away with it slightly because it was a poor width, but Amami not quite timing the volley.
Yeah, it was good to see her play that one as well, rather than try and get the stroke. Just she knew the space was there. Good composure. Doing really well here.
Just snatched at that one, got an opportunity. Maybe a rush of blood to the head, because it's not often you get those slightly loose volleys from someone like Kamami.
Oh,
it's nice.
Just somehow snuck that one above the tin. And a nice little bounce as well.
6-7.
Fantastic start for Pfister in this match.
Down.
Yeah, that ball was just
hand out. 8-6.
Running a little bit tight to go for that volley drop.
Game ball.
So Amami with 4 game balls. Nice. Lovely little trickle boast.
7-10, game ball.
Nice little variation there from Pfister.
Next time you gotta play the shot.
She was a little bit lucky to get that.
From the left, game ball.
Wasn't much interference there. Amami running in the forehand drop to take that opening game.
Egypt leads 1 game to love.
Didn't have it all her own way though. Nice to see. 7 minutes, El Hamami takes it 11-8.
Well, it's another solid start from superstar Egyptian team. Hania El Hamami coming out firing. But Nadia Pfister, Swiss, wasn't overawed, wasn't overwhelmed. That was a lovely shot, that forehand boast. There's another couple of occasions. That's another example of the Swiss playing some good squash. A nice smile after that backhand drop shot from the return of serve. But it's Hamami comes through. She leads by 1 game to love.
In 30 seconds. Egypt leads 1 game to love. Lobo. One love.
Well, fantastic first game there from Pfister. See what she can make of this second one. It's been pretty plain sailing for Egypt so far. It's nice to see a little bit of pushback from the Swiss team.
Hand out. One, two.
Comes to Pontefract pretty regularly, actually, Nadia Pfister. She's usually a couple of times a year for quite a few years, actually. She did quite a lot of work with Malcolm.
Yeah, I knew that. I didn't realise she was still coming.
Well, that she was obviously a couple of years with COVID, but she's been back since.
Just hit the top of the tin.
And for the backhand long range drop, she's done a fair few. Fair few hours of drop drive at Ponty. That definitely clipped the tin.
It did.
I'm not too sure, so let's play a let. One, two. From the right.
Ref unsighted, so we're going to play a let.
It's fortunate for Pfister here, just clipping the top of the tin, just deviated there. Our eagle eyes could see that. That's wonderful.
Hand out, 3-1.
Good attempt just to vary the angles there, but a little bit too slow and high. Mammy pouncing on that.
Down. Hand out, 2-3.
Well, don't forget, Mammy obviously very established on the World Tour, but this is her first time representing Egypt, so it's not something to be underestimated and not something she's experienced before either, so she'd be forgiven for having a few nerves.
Yeah, I think it's perhaps a combination of that and also Pfister's playing really well here. Look at this. She's reading the game pretty well. Mammy, she's onto the volley. She's really, really going for it, the Swiss here.
Right box, please.
Yeah, it's a bit of a combination of the two, isn't it? Pfister, obviously, with nothing to lose. Looks like she's enjoying the occasion, the chance to have a go. Arguably the best player in the world at the minute.
Oh, what a shot.
There's that backhand long drop again.
Ponty, long backhand drop shot, nice and straight. The first one, we both agree, was down, but that was brilliant. And really anticipating the volley as well, but she didn't quite get the line and the accuracy on that backhand, Pfister.
Hand out, 6-5.
Well, when she's getting those opportunities around the front, she's been very, very severe, taking a chance as well.
Hand out, 6-all.
Who was the best Egyptian player you played against, Vanessa?
Ooh, probably, I mean, I played Raneem once, but when she was very young, and played Altayeb a couple of times, but again, very
seven.
Good already.
12.
She was about 14, I think, not far off. But sort of consistently played was probably Omnia.
Yeah.
Omnia, who I think is, I can see in the background, sat there supporting
her, yes.
The team. She played 10 World Team Championships as well, apparently. I don't think they were consecutive, but...
She got to... She was top five, wasn't she? Top.
I'm not sure what her best ranking was, actually, but yeah.
Just that era before just before the rest of the superstars coming through.
Handout.
Raneem, of course, being a huge superstar. When you played the 14-year-old Raneem, did you think that she was going to do great things?
Yes, yeah. You could see the skill level, and she definitely. It was tough. Yeah, she's sending me the wrong way on quite a few occasions.
Down. Hand out, 8-9.
Oh, what a shot.
9-0.
Great confidence. In with a shout here of nicking the game for Switzerland.
Well, you can hear the Swiss team getting louder and louder in the background.
Well, I would say there'd be a huge roar if she did get the game, but it would be about four people.
Game ball.
Yeah. Hamami gets herself a single game ball. Yeah, it was the lift that did all the damage. Lovely lob into the back right. Hamami sneaking the second game. In 8 minutes, 11-9, and leads by 2 games to love.
Well, it's nice to see the Swiss players get a little bit closer, make it a little bit more competitive, as Fista did in that second game. Really impressive second game there for Nadia Fister of Switzerland. Got to at the point where it was 9-all and there was a really good opportunity for the Swiss perhaps to take first game for her team, or take a game for Switzerland in this very, very challenging task today. But look at that volley. I mean, there's some really confident shots from Fister. Just the wrong choice of shot right at the end of that game that gave Hamami the opportunity to put the ball away. 2-love. Hamami.
Women, 60 seconds. Play will resume in 30 seconds. Egypt leads 2 games to love.
Ball's called out on the front wall.
1-love.
Yeah.
Down. Two love.
Well, a couple of early errors from Pfister.
Three love.
Again, very, very attacking minded.
Pfister
being very proactive, looking for those short opportunities. Mami sometimes not quite finding the length that she would like.
Now.
Just lost the balance, lost the form there
and
a little bit, Pfister.
4-1.
Again, just guessing a little bit there, Hamami.
Hand out 5-2.
Yeah, she just looks ever so slightly flat, doesn't she, Hamami? It's obviously the fact that she's playing for a country for the first time in these championships, but also coming off the back of that huge, huge win in Hong Kong, and sort of the emotional come down of that. It was also two very, very tough matches to win that title in the semi-final and the final. So it's totally understandable that she'd be struggling to sort of get herself right back up for this match.
6-2.
And obviously with the strength of the team, she'll have the opportunities to sort of play her way into the event and possibly have a little rest in there as well. I'm surprised they played her actually
7-2.
In this opening match, considering what happened in Hong Kong. Yeah, nice finish there on the backhand.
8-3.
Big lead for Egypt in this third game, in this last match.
Down.
Yeah, it's running away from
three.
The Swiss now. She's played some good squash. Good little clips of her being very positive on the court against one of the best players in the world. But this third seemingly running away from her.
It's a squeezed error there for Hania El Hamami, and it gives her 7 match balls.
Down. Hand out 4-10 match ball.
thought that was going in, Vanessa. Five, really well played. Just clipping the top of the tin.
Yeah, it wasn't far off. Still five match balls remaining. There it is.
Three games to love. 11-8, 11-9, 11-5.
Mami closing out this tie between the number one seeds, Egypt, against Switzerland. Pfister playing fantastically well in that match. 25 minutes. Haniel Hamami taking it. Three games to love. 11-8, 11-9, 11-5. So Egypt taking this tie against Switzerland. Gohar with a 3-love win against Cindy Merlo. Nour El-Tayeb, 3-love against Amber Alinks. And then Haniel Hamami through in three against Nadia Pfister. So Egypt get their first points on the board in Pool A. So there you have it, a 3-love win for Egypt against Switzerland. And coming up at 7:30, it is United States, number two seeds, taking on Australia in just over 30 minutes' time. So we'll see you back then.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Women's World Team Championships in 2022 here in Cairo, in Egypt. This is Pool A, round one. And we have the US of A against Australia for this evening match following Egypt. Amanda Sobey of the US taking on Donna Lobben in this first match. Followed by Olivia Klein and Alex Hayden. And then finally, Olivia Fichter and Jessica Turnbull. Australia have had a really fantastic run since the inaugural event in 1979, winning 9 times Australia. They're in the very, very familiar colour of yellow and green, Australia.
Well, I think there's obviously an issue with the team order. We had Donna Lobben listed as the number one string.
It's Jessica Turnbull, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've been given false information. Apologies for that. So we have Jessica Turnbull up against Amanda Sobey. I think that's maybe why the referee was coming onto the court there. That's not the information that we were given.
Thank you, Amanda, for clarifying that. So there's just a little bit of confusion with the referees, who obviously had a different order, as did we.
Yeah, everyone looks pretty confused here.
I mean, like, one of the refs is there. One's just sitting
there. Well, we were told that it was Donna Lobben who was going to be up against Amanda Sobey.
May as well continue with the warm-up. Hopefully, by the time it's finished, things will have been cleared up with the referees. Jessica Turnbull there in the green and yellow and orange and blue.
Plenty of colours going on there. I think, well, hopefully this is going to remain as is. 27 years of age, Jessica Turnbull, currently 77 in the world. She played the Commonwealth Games, I believe, in Birmingham. She's been as high as 69. She's up against the familiar face of Amanda Sobey. She was the first US player, man or woman, to reach the top 5 in the world. She is currently ranked 5 in the world, 29 years of age, and of course a Harvard graduate, spearheading this very, very strong US team this year. Number 2 seeds, of course, behind Egypt, who are just insanely strong. Become rather a lacklustre warm-up because just the confusion, I think, Vanessa. I don't know if this has ever happened to you where you've walked on court with somebody that you weren't expecting.
No, I can't say it has. Obviously, there's a quite strict rules about putting your team order in. And I believe if you're playing your standard 1-2-3 player, then you don't have to do anything. Then that's what the team is.
It's assumed then, isn't it, if you don't sort of communicate.
Yeah. So if you're dropping any one of those top three players, then you have to put that order in. I think it used to be, was it an hour before the match?
Yes, before the tie? Yeah. That's usually the case in these team events.
See, something's gone a bit wrong there. You could see the Aussie coach, Stuart Boswell, put his head through the door. He's possibly trying to sort things out.
There we have the correct team sheet. Amanda Sobey versus Jessica Turnbull, not Don Lobben. Olivia Klein versus Sarah Cardwell. And then finally, Olivia Fichter versus Alex Hayden. That's a little bit more work for us as commentators to do, Vanessa. Just to rejig things a little bit. With better get researching again on your iPad that doesn't work. Start all over again.
Slightly sketchy internet.
Yeah, we just saw Stuart Boswell advising Jessica Turnbull, former world top five player himself.
We lost a few numbers in the crowd since Egypt got safely Women's through their first
team
match.
Women's World Team Final Championship 2022, Pool B match. Jessica from Australia to serve Amanda Sobhi of United States to receive best of five games in love all.
Just Jessica, Jess, kicking off the match.
Wow, it's all happening here.
And out one love.
Did you see Turnbull play in the Commonwealth Games, Vanessa? I'm pretty sure she was there.
Two love.
In Birmingham, playing a bit of doubles as well.
Yeah, no, I don't think I did. I was there watching it live for a couple of the days.
Yeah, I saw you. Saw you on the beep.
And some of the early rounds were a bit hard to find. Took a little while for the BBC to realise there's some decent squash going on.
Surprising. Pretty attacking player, quite proactive on
and
the court, Turnbull. And you could certainly say that about Amanda Sobey. One of the most attacking players on the tour, one of the best volleyers. We were talking about the attributes of Nuriel Tayeb and Nora Gohar, and you have to say Sobey's one of the best volleyers around.
Yeah, the lefty, obviously, really strong on that forehand side, especially on the volley. She's got a lot of options if she's given the ball on that side. Uses good variation and a lot of power as well.
And out 3-2.
Certainly an area for Turnbull to try to keep the ball away from, that sort of shoulder height volley.
And out 3-0.
To Sobey's forehand, it's on the left-hand side.
And out out. Hand out 4-3. Hand out 4-5. Down. Hand out 6-4.
Well, the temperature has dropped quite a bit in the last couple of hours. You can see that.
7-4.
Court playing quite differently from that opening match.
Do you think that will help USA a little bit or hinder them?
I mean, it'll help the player who adapts well to the environment, which obviously with Sobey's experience on glass courts, I would expect her to do, and it does suit her game as well. She's very accurate.
8-4.
Sure, she won a couple of times at the Oracle NetSuite in San Francisco, and that was an outdoor court which got sometimes quite cold in the evenings in September, sort of late September in San Francisco.
9-4.
The cold sea air coming in.
Yeah, cold court, best of three. She probably had a few 10-minute matches.
She had a riot, and unsurprisingly, Rami Ashour was pretty good at that event as well.
10-4, game ball.
So six games balls here for Amanda Sobey.
Stroke to United States. 11-4, game to United States. United States leads 1-0.
So looking good there, Amanda Sobey against Jessica Turnbull, not Donna Lobben, taking the first game 11-4 in just 5 minutes, leading 1-0.
Well, Turnbull getting off to a good start in that first game for Australia, but it was Sobey that worked her way into the game, started to find the corners, get a feel for the court, and really pulled away towards the end of that first. Quick points on the board and reasonably comfortable in the end, taking that opening game. So 1-0 to the USA.
See Amanda Sobey having a word with the USA coach Ong Beng He, former Malaysian number one and world top 10 player. So a world junior champion when he first came on the scene, very experienced.
Resume in 60 seconds. United States leads 1-0. Love all. Out. 1-0. Hand out 1-0.
Well, Sobey should be reasonably fresh coming into this. She opted not to play in Hong Kong.
2-1.
Only played the Singapore Open out of that sort of tour. Played very well in Singapore, just lost out to Taieb, if I remember correctly.
Stroke to United States.
See, a lot of the players had this event in the back of their mind,
and out two,
knowing
three.
That it's a really, really tough week, particularly for the number one strings, who even in the pool matches three often old. Have the tougher matches. Long season ahead as well.
Four, three.
That's a lovely shot. She had the time, of course, but
six,
just set
three.
It up nicely. So it'd be perfect length on that backhand side.
Out. 7-3.
Sure, if you know Vanessa, but this might be the first time that she would have played in the World Team Championships with her sister.
And that's
because the
four,
fact that it was 28, it was 4 years ago that the last one took place. And she would have played together in the, and obviously Pan Am and stuff like that. But
yeah, I'm not sure if Sabrina made the team.
Four.
She's just that
in
bit
China.
Younger.
Yeah.
She may have
snuck in. I'm not sure.
Great relationship those two, and I know that. Amanda's very proud
four.
Of her sister getting in the team with her and making it just that bit stronger.
Down. And out. 5-9.
Amanda's been playing for the USA for quite a while. I remember her playing in my last one, which was 2010. And that may have been her first outing, actually,
out
the World Teams.
Five, game ball.
It's nice from Turnbull.
Hand
good positive
six,
finish,
ten.
Looking for that volley.
Game ball.
Taking her opportunity. A little bit high on that boast, and she
11,
got punished by Sobey.
United States,
onto
United
it
leagues.
Really fast.
Two games to love.
Read it nice and early. Still looking very, very confident. Another 5 minute game for Sobey, taking the second 11-6. She leads by two games to love.
There is Stuart Boswell. National coach in Australia for the past few years.
Yeah, he was a fantastic player. I played against him a few times. Very, very difficult to break down. So accurate. It's pinpoint precision on the court. And off the court. Very humble and... quietly spoken guy, good sense of humour. Got to number four in the world, I think, but had quite a few injuries. Could have perhaps done even better and won some major events, but he was a fantastic player. That's a lovely shot from Sobey. That's typical lefty forehand volley. It was slightly behind her, difficult to read, well executed.
Yeah, she hits a good boast. Sobey, off the bounce and on the volley.
Down.
I was out up there, FYI.
Well, the ball was just called down.
Too low.
Oh. He's,
he's changed his mind. No one would hear, but we did.
we
in our earphones.
That.
Just caught the nick, didn't it? It's a bit funny, but it was good.
Players didn't hear anything, thankfully.
Three love. Down. Five love. Hand out 1-5.
Well, just looking through the record books, Vanessa, Australia are actually the leaders in terms of amount of wins for this World Team Championships. 9 they have.
Hand out 6-1.
England on 7. USA have never won this before.
Hand out 2-6.
In 2010 that Australia last won this event. Donald Lobben was actually a part of that, who's not playing tonight.
Yeah, that was in Palmerston North in New Zealand that year. Yeah, they've had some unbelievable teams, Australia, over the years. Just dropped away over the last few years since the Grinhams retired.
Yeah, and it's resulted in, the fact that they haven't won it for 12 years, that's resulted in them being unseeded in this event. It was only a matter of time, really, that the USA, particularly the women, were going to be so strong, wasn't it, in squash. It's just, the writing's been on the wall. The last decade or so.
Down.
Oh, just missing that one, but it's good to see that we could have a bit of a challenger to Egypt, perhaps if they all play well on the day. If they get there, of course, there's still other challengers like England.
Turnbull again doing well, the early stages of this third game.
Yeah, she's certainly not being intimidated on that.
Down.
They're just looking for the volley, but ball was a little bit too tight for that attempt. There you see Donald Lobben on the left with Stuart Boswell in the middle. Brilliant shot from Turnbull. She's managed to straighten that one. A bit of a wry smile from the Aussie
8-6.
So we just had one extra shot here.
Oh, lucky little bounce.
Hand out 7.
Coming at a
eight.
Good time for Turnbull. Just as Sobey was threatening to pull away again at the end of this third.
Well, that's disappeared, I think. She's not too impressed with herself there, Turnbull. Might have to request a new ball again. As we said, it just goes flying above the rafters. Probably landed in on a hockey pitch or something, paddle court. Yeah, it's definitely a new ball there, Vanessa. You can tell by the way it's not bouncing.
I think we're going to be seeing this quite a lot this week. As you said, as soon as that ball goes over the front wall, that's it. New ball straight on the court. Nobody's even bothering to look.
I was just thinking who we could employ as a ball person, Vanessa.
Ladies and gentlemen, a new ball has added. Player will start moving it up until it becomes playable. And out 9-7.
Well, I think the ball is sufficiently warm now, Vanessa. Some good volleying going on from both players. That's a fantastic shot to give herself 3 match balls now, Amanda Sobey. Absolutely brilliant. Shot down, serve down the middle. Just keeping the Aussie honest. Just missed it. The right shot to go for there. Nice smile from both players. It was good effort from the Aussie. Certainly didn't back down in terms of her attacking play. But Amanda Sobey, just a little bit too much quality, the American. Coming through 11-4, 11-6, 11-7 in just 21 minutes. 3 games to love. So, as I just said, Sobey coming through quite comfortably. Next match on court will be Olivia Klein versus Sarah Cardwell. Hopefully that will be the right match and the correct players. That'll be coming up, hopefully, in a few minutes. Yeah.
Test.
Thank you.
Half time.
Well, here we have the second match on court between the USA and Australia, the number three string between Olivia Klein, you see in the black top on the left-hand side of the USA, up against Sarah Cardwell from Australia. Sarah Cardwell, 31 years of age. Mum is Vicky Cardwell, who won of British Opens back in the day. I remember watching her on the BBC in the early 80s. Sarah Cardwell, currently 69 in the world rankings. She's up against a very talented Olivia Klein, who's currently 20 in the world. Very skillful player, 29 years of age. Klein. Her husband is Alan Klein, former Scottish international. Of course, USA have the advantage with the 1-0 win so far from Amanda Sobey. Klein has the chance here to secure it for the USA.
Yep, and she is certainly favourite to do so on paper. Cardwell, pretty experienced, been on tour a while. Joy is playing for her country.
You said you played against her mum, Vicky. Have you played against Sarah as well?
I haven't actually, no.
You played the mother-daughter combo.
No, I played Vicky a couple of times, I think, just right at the end of her career. She played on until she was well into her 40s.
Play restored in 15 seconds.
Tough competitor, very feisty.
Yeah, I certainly remember that. I was a young kid watching her back in the day when she was winning British Opens.
Sarah of Australia to serve, Livia Klein of United States to receive, best of five game, Lavol.
There we go. Sarah Cardwell kicking off for Australia. Crucial match for the Aussies here, this group match against the USA. The number two seeds here.
And a nice start for Cardwell, running in the backhand drop. Nice tight. And again.
Two love.
Lovely.
That's beautiful. Really nice touch. What a start for the Aussie.
Playing the court very well. There's a lot of reward to be had. If you get the ball tucked into the corners, looking quite dead out there.
Down. Hand out, 1-3.
Yeah, the temperature's dropped to currently 16 degrees here in Cairo, which is very happy with in the UK, wouldn't we, at the moment? But
yeah, but for an outdoor squash court.
Yeah, just a little bit chilly.
Yeah. Nice and very cold weather coming in this weekend.
Yeah, that we're going to miss.
Home. Yeah. Kids might be out sledging.
Out.
Very Christmassy.
3-4.
I've been playing, I don't know about you, but I've been playing lots of Christmas tunes in my room just to get me in the festive spirit.
Don't want to know what you do in your room.
At least I've got security now, the door locks properly.
Right side.
Pretty good at that backhand drop shot, Cardwell.
Yeah, she's getting
and out five,
a lot
four.
Of result from that shot.
Well, Klein is known for her racket skills, but Sarah Cardwell is matching her at the moment. That's a great shot.
And out 5-5. Six, five.
I just missed timing that. Sort of
right
half
side.
Volley.
Out 6-7.
Well, tough to get any rallies on here at the minute.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not, at least it's not a wind going on. Definitely is quite cool on there.
And out 8-6.
You must have had some Australian idols that you looked up to and played. Were you coached by Liz Irving? Is that correct?
Yeah, for a while. Yeah. And played Michelle quite a few times, Michelle Martin and Fitzy got battered quite a few times by both of them.
Yeah, I'm sure when you were younger. Liz Irving, of course, former 96. World number two, British Open finalist, I think, a couple of times, maybe three times, in fact. Didn't quite get over the line, but fantastic player.
Carol Owens as well, very successful.
10-6 game ball.
So four game balls for the United States in this second match. It's another lost ball. Oh, I bet you can see it coming down. Oh no, that's not. It's an insect.
United States leads one game to love.
Klein looking pretty comfortable there. She's going to take care of this insect too. Hope she's going to be kind.
She tried to use a racket rather than a hand. Oh dear.
No, not kind. Ruthless. So Olivia Klein taking the first game 11-6 in 5 minutes. She leads by one game to love.
Well, good start for Cardwell. Put quite a few points on the board with that backhand drop, running in nicely. Ball staying really tight into all the corners. But Klein just started to find her range a little bit more from the mid stage onwards. And that ball running into the back. And was able to close the game out. So getting off to a good start for USA in this second match, looking to close out the tie.
Fifteen seconds. United States leads one game to love. Love all.
Well, solid start for Klein, looking in good order here.
Down.
She misses that backhand volley
and
drop shot.
One love.
Klein just taking a little bit of time to find her targets in that first game. Maybe might see her go up a gear in this second.
No let.
Yeah, not quite enough effort to go through there. Wasn't a huge amount of interference.
Hand out 2-1.
Not a single review so far, Parky, tonight.
Wow.
Hand out 2-0.
Don't jinx it, Vanessa.
Video referee.
Easy night for them.
Yeah, having a nap.
Klein pouncing two. Onto that one, nice and early.
Thank you.
It's very honest there from Klein. Just a bit of a carry off the side wall,
and
not clean.
3-0.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nice little bit of deception there from Klein.
And out 4-3.
Came in with the high racket preparation. Good control on the drop.
No let. And out 4-4.
Just absolutely no pace on that ball.
Oh, just clipped the side wall, but got away with it because Cardwell just not there in time. It's everything pretty quickly, doesn't she, Klein? Even bouncing the ball.
6-4.
It's a good change of direction from Cardwell.
5-6. And out 7-5. Hand out 6-7. Hand out 8-6.
Pretty sharp onto that one, Klein.
Down. Hand out.
Gotta be careful here, Klein. Cardwell is hanging in there pretty well. Just keeping in touch on the scoreboard. Bit of pressure. She needed that one.
And
it was a big miss, really, wasn't it, Vanessa?
Seven.
Yeah, there's certainly an opportunity to get quick points on the board here. The rally's rarely going beyond 4 or 5 shots. Nice height, backhand there.
Up.
That's a beautiful shot. Just the right shot as well. Good awareness from Klein. Not
10-7,
a lot of players would come in here and just try and whack that aimlessly, but just taking the pace off it, cutting it nice and low. And it's 3 game balls for Klein and the United States. It's well played from Cardwell.
Hand out, 8-10 game ball.
Just all about getting onto that early and hitting with pace. Oh, she's done it. I think she got that. Cardwell's just having a quiet word, but it's definitely good from Klein. She managed to dig it out of the nick and take the second game. 11-8 in 7 minutes. The American leads by 2 games to love.
Well, the court looking increasingly cold and dead. And that creates huge distances on the court, anything loose, and it's pretty much game over. Or if you leave the ball sitting up in the front, and then you can find those back corners, that's the same result. Very difficult to play in these conditions. It becomes a little bit of a shootout. Cardwell doing pretty well, taking her opportunities, but again, Klein pulling away towards the end. Two love lead for the USA.
Blue resume in 60 seconds. They resume in 30 seconds. United States leads to game to love. Love all. One love.
Oh, that is a beautiful finish there from the Aussie. She seemed to have all the time in the world, and that can create problems sometimes. Here we go. Look at this roller. Beautiful.
Yeah, she's got a lot of skill around the front. Oh, she got herself nice and low for that one.
She did, but it was just a little bit too late. It was as she was coming down, wasn't it? I think that's why she made the error. She was kind of
2-1.
Yeah, she was too late.
Too late to bend. Beautiful shot there. Beautiful skill from
3-1.
Klein. Great technique.
Hand out 2-3. Out. Hand out 4-2. Stroke to Australia. Hand out 3-4.
That it's just a wry smile. I mean, it was the right shot to play.
5-4.
Open goal though, really. Usually bread and butter for Klein.
Well, if you miss that first shot in, leave that ball sitting up, there's absolutely no chance of getting the next one back. You have to be very severe on this court.
And that's very, very tight. Very, very six, tight. Five. Good squeeze from the American. Yeah. Nicely done.
Took it early.
7-5.
Didn't need to take a lot of risk, just needed to get on it nice and early.
And out, 6-7. And out, 8-6. And out, 7-8.
Still in with a shot here, Cardwell. Just as I say that, completely misreads that volley boast from
9-7.
Klein. Brilliant shot though. They all went the wrong way on that one. Just hit it so late. So just 2 points away now from securing this win for the US.
Yes, clipping the tin.
8-9.
Just trying a bit too much there, perhaps, Klein. The ball was quite low and tight, and she attempted a flick. We've got total parity now here in the third game. Cardwell just using her experience, just taking her time on that serve.
Oh,
oh dear me.
Hand out.
That's
10-9.
An unbelievable bit of fortune there for Klein. Giving her a match ball here. Yeah, it's a good finish from Klein.
It's
looking quite tricky there towards the end of the third, but just a little bit of luck there in the back right corner for Klein. She takes the match 11-6, 11-8, 11-9 in 23 minutes. Three games to love.
Well, difficult conditions out there. Very short rallies, and Cardwell playing pretty well, taking her chances, had a few winners. A lot of skill around the front of the court, but Klein, as you said, Parky, just doing enough, getting that ball, just running into the back and then opening up around the front of the court. So, closing out the match, another three love win for the USA, and they have a two-match lead now against Australia.
So 2-3 love wins for the USA, which means that they have beaten Australia, but there's still one match to play, which is Olivia Fichter and Alex Hayden. That will still be a best of five, and that will follow in a few minutes. Well, welcome back to this third and final match between the USA and Australia. The USA have already secured this fixture, winning the first two matches, both in three straight sets. But this one will still be a best of five between Olivia Fichter on the left-hand side in the blue top, up against the youngster, Alex Hayden, from Australia, just 21 years of age. Well, Alex Hayden played in the doubles in the Commonwealth Games with Jessica Turnbull. She also played in the World Doubles pre-COVID back in 2019. So sounds like she enjoys that version of the game. She's been on the PSA World Tour since 2018, but of course we had COVID for a couple of years and she won't have had as much experience as she would have liked, I guess. But that experience in Birmingham would have stood her in good stead for these kind of events on the grass court. She's got a difficult task today, up against someone who has got quite a bit of experience in big events in the last couple of years. Olivia Fichter, the USA, managed to get to the semi-finals of the US Open. Currently 10 in the world, 27 years of age, from Philly. This is going to be the final match of this evening. What do you think, Vanessa?
Well, Fichter in pretty good form. I watched her make it through to the final in Malaysia quite recently, just lost out to Naila Hillis in that final, but she played really well. She was very disappointed, but because she had certainly had her chances.
Yeah, that was a great match, great final there. She's certainly very, very close.
World Team Championships 2022. Pool B match, Alex Hayden of Australia to serve, Olivia Fichter of United States to receive. Best of five games, level.
So here we go, final match of the day on this glass court, outdoors here in Cairo. Nice shot from Hayden. Doesn't look too nervous on there, the youngster. Six years between these two. Fichter, 27 years of age.
The
lost ball. Sure how many balls we've got for this tournament, Vanessa, but Stuart Boswell quite comfortably catches that ball like a cricketer then. Throwing the ball back into the court. Very smoothly done.
3-1. Three, luck. Hand out 2-3. Stroke to United States. And out 4-3.
Well, this is Olivia Fichter's first time representing the USA at a World Team Championships.
5-3.
So, as established as she is on the World Tour, this is a new experience.
Yeah, it's happened a few times. It happened with Mami, didn't it? You wouldn't expect that, but I guess that's just because the last one was so long ago.
Yeah.
COVID in the way. Some of these players, relatively
six,
young,
three.
Medium age, I guess, have just blossomed in the last couple of years.
Stroke to United States. 7-3.
Surprised she didn't sort of go for the shape for the volley there and take the stroke, but she.
9-3.
It's good to see. Going to take it off the back wall. Looking in good form here, Fichter.
Yeah, slightly longer rallies so far in this match. Fichter plays a bit more of a structured game. Tries to really set herself up well in the back before she takes the ball in short.
So seven game balls for the USA. Yeah, that's right, Vanessa. She doesn't really do anything too ambitious, Fichter. Everything, like you say, is very structured, very accurate. Mainly plays the right shot at the right time.
It's
got a good engine on her too, so it's quite hard to break her down, really. Find those weaknesses. If you were playing. If you were coaching somebody that was playing her, what would you say?
Yeah, she is quite a difficult one to work out because she's quite all round. She doesn't have any sort of obvious weaknesses. Certainly in the couple of matches that I've seen her where she lost out to Hillis, it was more a question of wearing her down, really.
Well, a real battle of fitness, that, isn't it, with Hillis, because she's one of the fittest players on tour, but so is Fichter, and she's taken the first game 11-4 in 7 minutes, leading one game to love.
Well, good start for Fichter and her first outing for the USA in the World Team Champs. Again, that very structured play, finding those back corners early on, court looking a little bit livelier due to the slightly longer rallies, and then opening up into the front of the court. High percentage stuff, but executed very, very well.
resume in 30 seconds. United States leads ball game to Love. Love.
That's a nice finish. Very, very controlled there from Victor. Very much a no-nonsense player.
Yeah, she is. Just gets on with the business at hand.
Sink into that one. It was the right shot to play, but perhaps just a little bit too upright. It's a nice play from the Aussie. The youngster looking very, very confident. When she gets the opportunities, you can see she's bouncing up to the ball nice and early. Not so much on that one, but the previous couple of rallies, she was very, very confident and proactive. That's a beautiful shot. Just got exactly the right timing.
3-2.
And as Hayden was coming in to try and retrieve, it was very, very tight to the side wall.
4-2.
That's a good finish.
Left side, 5-2.
Very assured on those volleys. Hayden just going to take care not to give her opponent too much time around the middle.
Yeah, she hasn't done badly, really, Hayden so far, but it's been very clinical from Victor. Oh, not sure why she didn't hit that one.
Yeah, I agree with you, Vanessa. The ball was just slightly behind her. I don't think that would have been particularly unsafe to flick it straight, but playing a let. Starting to get forced more into some awkward positions here, the Aussie. Just trying a little bit too much whilst under pressure. Shots like that from the returner serve. Didn't quite make it, that one.
7-2.
It's a good get from Victor.
Game ball.
clever shot from Victor. Perfect lob, winning that second game on the lob. It's always a nice shot to win on, to play a winner on, turning defence into attack.
Went for the little three-wall boast in there as well.
Absolutely. So Victor moving really well, looking very, very comfortable and assured out there, taking the second game 11-2 in 5 minutes, leading two games to love.
Well, very business-like performance so far from Olivia Fichter. She's just hitting all four corners really well, hitting really good weight of shot into the back, and then Hayden just getting picked off around the middle. Very few errors and good accurate squash from Fichter, who's looking pretty solid. Two love, looking to close this out.
So here we go. What can Alexandra Hayden do here against a very highly ranked opponent, very experienced? I think she's doing pretty well, to be honest, Vanessa.
Well, Fichter is in pretty good form. We've seen a couple of these matches where, you know, there's been a strong favourite, but they haven't necessarily shown up with their best form. But Fichter's been really solid. Looking like she just wants to get this done.
Well, absolutely, and that's the way it's got to be. It's going to be a long week, isn't it? Even if there are a couple of fairly comfortable matches for these top players, you have to get the job done and save every ounce of energy for potentially a tough semi and a very tough final.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, you know, it's not a small thing playing in this event for the first time. And there's a little bit of wanting to prove yourself and just wanting to start off well. Show why you deserve this place.
Yeah, just the wrong shot there from Hayden. He's trying to take the ball when it's virtually on the ground by shoelaces. Oh dear. It's very unusual for Victor. Just a slight loss of concentration there for the American.
Out
Out.
Good hustling here from Alex Hayden. Good pressure in turn from the experienced Victor. Just taking the ball back into those back corners, not taking any risks, trying to put a little bit more work physically into her opponent. And it's paying off. But again, Alex Hayden not going away here. Just making herself as tough and as stubborn as possible in this match.
Stroke to United States. 7-6.
Hayden doing really well in this third game.
Yeah, she's stuck in well. I've been impressed with her. Said she's only seen her really in the doubles in the Commonwealth Games. Just starting out on the World Tour in terms of actual tournaments played. COVID getting in the way, but it's a good effort here. She's in with a shot in this third game still.
Yeah, trying to ruin the clean score sheet for the United States. Just as Victor pulls away again, 2-point lead, 2 points away.
Well, it's a good point you make there, Vanessa, because I'm sure that Victor will not want to lose a game as US teammates didn't. They'll be very competitive with each other. And that's very healthy, I think, for a team spirit, but also to see who can do the best, especially in the group matches.
Ten-seven match ball.
So it was 3 match balls, 2 match balls now.
And
another opportunity for Alex Hayden to stay in this third, potentially take it to a tie break. Nice early volleying from the Aussie here. Yeah, it's a nice finish.
11-8.
Just cutting down the risk there from Olivia Victor, making sure she also does have a clean sheet, winning 11-4, 11-2, 11-8. 3 love in 22 minutes. USA come through. 3 love against Australia.
Well, a lot better from Hayden in that third game, able to create a little bit of pressure for her opponent, but Victor up to the task. Really solid performance overall. Responded well at the end of that third game and closed it out nicely. Cleaning up for the USA, number 2 seeds through 3 love against Australia.
Well, there we have the 2 team results from today. Earlier, Egypt coming through quite comfortably 3 love against Switzerland, and then you just saw the United States, the number 2 seeds, coming through 3 love against Australia. Well, thank you very much for joining us today. Play resumes tomorrow at 6 p.m., so we'll see you then. Thank you.